Good evening, all you awesome people. Silver Dragon here, coming at you with some more From the Depths. Now, I hadn't actually intended to do anything on this, well, today at least, or tonight, but I will be doing a short little video, because let me actually load our previous game here, then I will continue. For those that have read the announcement page or read, you know, paid attention to the forums for this game, and I would definitely suggest you reading the forums. I do not spend nearly enough time on the forums for this game. I really don't. But the dev announced a new addition, or well, a couple new additions to the campaign, change-wise at least. Essentially, what's going to be happening... Oh, and I clicked outside the game, and now shit is going crazy, and... Oh, wait, I loaded the wrong save, I think. Wait, what? What save is the right save? I don't know. Oh, this one is. Okay. I forgot. I was experimenting with this version, I think, and that's why it was still back a bit. I think. I don't know. I hope. But yeah, essentially there's a lot of really, really cool stuff coming to the campaign here soon. Which means that more than likely, once again, we're going to want to reset back from the beginning. Now, I might not have, I'm pretty sure I don't have to completely reset from the beginning. But because these changes are really, like, all-encompassing and sweeping in a way, it's probably going to be a good idea if I restart from the beginning. So, what do I do with this then? Now, this update is roughly scheduled to be released on the 8th, he mentioned, of this month. So, don't hold me to that, don't hold him to that. You know, development happens if some massive, ridiculous bug of insanity pops up where he absolutely has to get it done. You know, delay it to fix it, then that's just what's going to happen. So, yeah. So, the question is, what the heck are we going to do with this ship and this LP? Well, I am going to leave that to you guys for now. Come the 8th, I will be doing a lot of stuff on qubetubers for their Child's Play Indie Weekend event. So I'll be streaming this game, I'll be streaming several other games, probably over the weekend, so I'll be doing a lot of streaming on QT. I will also post a link to that down below in the description. So, before that happens, I want to do something glorious with this campaign. At the very least, you know, this thing's not going down without a fight. We are going to do something nice with this. So, definitely send me your suggestions. What do you guys think I should do? Just piss off everybody? You know, put rockets on the back of this thing, crash it into the side of a mountain? You know, what do you want me to do with this ship and this this campaign right here? And I will see what I can do. But of course, last time I did mention that, you know, I did want to set this turret a different way, and apparently I can still do so if I were to go, like, let me show an example here. Go into custom cannons, multipurpose laser, laser transceiver, point up. Let's go blocks, wooden block, wooden block. Wait, fuck? Oh, wait, what? What's happening? What's happening? Oh, yeah, apparently I can't build on these. Eh, whatever, let me go like this then. Haha, I have defied you. That's probably high enough. Now, apparently it's supposed to work something along the lines of this, though I may be mistaken. Let's just go put a basic precision turret up top here for now. Go back to custom lasers. Now, I'm not sure if just a simple laser combiner here would connect up. I don't think it would. Nope. How about a connector? I don't think that's quite doing it either. Another way I might be able to do this is something like this, where I go and put a laser transceiver on like so. And that might connect up and feed back in like that. So now I can go on top here. I can go laser combiner. Bunch of laser steering optics. Whoops. Fly higher, damn you. I thought I have rockets for feet. Damn it. Oh my god. I think I need a more stable platform. This is not working too well. Okay. And now suddenly I have a mobile death beam. So this is one way we could do it. And get ourselves a mobile death beam. I don't think it actually directly transitions through, but I'm not 100% sure. There could be another piece that I could connect, like, right here, and then the connector in front of it. The, what the hell is it called? Let me click build. Oh, and apparently I'm building way the hell away. The combiner. So, something like, well, the connector didn't work. The laser coupler might work. A multipurpose laser block might work. Or just doing something like this with the laser transceiver pointing down and linking up to it. I'm not sure if this one just pointing up into something like this might work. As a matter of fact, you know, let's go ahead and test that. Let's put the multi-purpose laser block right here. And see if that creates a connected beam. It did not. How about the laser coupler? It did not. So it seems like I might have to do something along those lines of having it just pointing down like that. Seems to be the way to get it done. So back to the connector, transceiver straight down, and there we go. We have a stable working laser beam of death. Ha ha! Ha ha! So this is how I could have done this up front here. And that way it's actually mobile. I can even replace this with an actual like 360 turret and steer it around. I could also, let me remove this here for a second. Or not, because I'm building on this turret right now. Build. For an anti-airship kind of thing, I could go something like... I don't know, that's a bit ridiculous, to be honest. Yeah, it's actually quite ridiculous. But hey, anything that goes above me would be like just getting blasted by this thing. You know, that's actually a pretty wide degree of fire, I would say. So if I set this up to an AI core and had an enemy airship coming at me, this would probably work fairly effectively. It's got a pretty wide field of fire, like this. Obviously it's a, you know, horrifying looking tower of just mirrors, but still kind of functions. Alright, let's go ahead and remove these. Well, I'm not going to save this save anyway, so we're just kind of doing examples here. So there's many ways you can set up these laser systems. I could also have combined it all into, like, one tower like this, where I just kind of, you know, go right underneath like so, put in... Oh, actually, it's wrong one. I would have to put the multipurpose laser block like so, and then... laser couplers. I probably just either side. Then put in like, oh, fail. You know, something along the lines of this. Let me go ahead and pop on the. You know what, that's fine. I'm not trying to make anything amazing here. Let me just put on frequency doubler, stabilizer, frequency doubler, destabilizer. And this could all be like underneath the actual, the ship itself, and then... Oh, yeah, I forgot about the laser cue switch. Derp. Derp. And one thing that I also did not do properly last time, I believe you can actually hook up, the more of these Q-switches you hook up, if I'm understanding this correctly, the faster it will actually fire. Let me try it with all of them and then with less. Let me see if I can fly back up or not. Rocket boots, go! Love my rocket boots. Okay. Oh, Jesus. Pew, 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 pew. Oh, God, we are lighting that mountain up. I'm gonna write my name in this freaking mountain. Let's see. S? Nope, that's not an S. Is it Zorro? Am I summoning Zorro? Nope, no, not quite. So, yes, adding more Q-switches does this. Pew, 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 pew. Now, of course, if I were to do something like... Well, let me stop rotating around like a fool. quickly. Wait, what the hell is this? Oh, it's a multi-purpose laser block. Let's hope this works. Alright. Aw, yeah, now I got a great platform. Let's give them death! Holy crap. Okay. Obvious, I think it's completely obvious what the next step to this system has to be. Completely obvious. Laser connector, that is correct. Steering optics. Nope, one back. Oh, I'm out of energy. I'm out of scrap. Well, scrap. Let's go ahead and gather some, shall we? Tra-la-la-la. Okay, we'll just remove these little bits and pieces right here. It's not like we need these right now. But yes, we are going to totally... because I'm screwing around like this right now, and, you know, doing this for the hell of it, we will be getting into a battle with this just to see how effective this thing truly is. Because I'm insane like that. Oh, I forgot to put the mirror mode back on. Eh. There we go. Oh, for the love of God. Ah, whatever. It doesn't need that much of a firing angle, so you know what? Let me remove. Whole sections of this. Since apparently they require a massive amount of space. I don't even know where I am anymore, man. Okay, it's 3, it looks like. Nice. Oh, man, this is definitely a wall of absolute despair. So, in order to make it a wall of even further absolute despair... what the hell am I looking for? Laser pumps. Because obviously right now it's not that powerful. So, we're gonna fix that. One second. I don't even care about any of these ones right now. I just want to build this death machine up here and get it fully functional and... There we go. Oh, this is gonna be good. This is gonna be good. I actually had an intention to further extend this, but screw it. Where the heck is the... There we go. That's not that great for damage, but let me actually go on the end here. And, because I still have it on. All right. Frequency doubler. Let me actually put on mirror mode. Beautiful. That should crank this baby up a little bit more. Oh, yeah. All right. I have to set every single one. Well, let me go like this here. Let me set this to 4. And where the heck? Copy the clipboard, paste the clipboard. I cannot apply this to every single one touching it, though, which kind of sucks. Screw it, we'll set you to all then. Alright, take me to another zone. Let's engage this. Engage. So I'm just going to pilot this thing, turn the engines on, turn it towards the enemy, and just crank up the throttle and get up on front and see if I can blast it. I'll probably die. It probably won't work all that well, but you know what? We're going to try. We're going to try firing the wall of death. Let me fire these missiles first, I guess. Apologies for the erape. Alright. But yes, apologies for that mild amount of ear rape. Okay, so this thing is just paddling forward now. It is completely outside of my control. Oh my god, that's ridiculous. I love it. Now if only it's close enough to hit. One sec, let me pause this for a moment. Let me turn this down overall so we're not all getting completely and utterly ear obliterated. Oh my god, it's horrible. If only you were a little bit more forward. Faster! Fast! Oh, it's hitting! It's hitting! Shred them, my beauties! Shred them! Death to the enemy! Death to the enemy! Wow, this is actually not doing a lot of damage, but of course this is also a weak pump. So this is a very weak laser, but still, it is pretty cool how cool this actually is. Let's see if I can take out that guy's gun. Oh. I'm not getting close enough to that guy to really get him, but hey. I wonder if I could somehow, yeah, I could probably increase the armor piercing value of this, because we're hitting the enemy, you can see we're like, really wailing into him, but we're not doing practically any damage. At all, it seems. Like, look at that. We're, yeah, barely doing a thing to him. I guess an enemy's supposed to keep a certain distance from us. Take out the balloons. Take out everything. Still, this was a pretty fun little experiment here, just messing around like that. So there's a couple different ways we can actually do these turrets. But, anyway. Once again, oh, and also about hijacking an enemy ship. If you hop on them, let me see if I can find their AI core here quickly. Here it is. What the heck? Let me go minigun. AI core destroyed. Okay, this thing is no longer being piloted by the AI. Because somebody did ask me about hijacking an enemy ship. So, congratulations, I've hijacked an enemy ship. I am now piloting it around like a boss. I can build on it. Oh, actually, wait. I take that back. I cannot build on it. I cannot repair it because it is not my ship. So yes, if you wanted to, you can hijack an enemy ship like this and pilot it around. But you cannot take it anywhere with you, like if I try to go somewhere else. We're obviously under attack by the enemy, so I can't do a damn thing anyway. But yeah, I can't actually do anything. minigun! Minigun! What the hell is this thing? Minigun! Boom! Oh no! Whee! I can fly! Splat. Actually, it's kind of funny. For some reason, I took over the... I'm the copter guy when I died, but I'm the other robot when I'm alive. That's kind of weird. Bug report. So yeah, there is some really cool stuff. And I actually didn't even really mention what's coming in on the campaign, did I? Yeah. My bad. That's actually completely my bad. I somehow managed to completely forget to mention all the cool stuff that's coming. Let's see if we can take over the ship, though, while I'm doing that. Essentially, the campaign map is becoming one big open map. So instead of just having, like, these little tiles, or we might still have these tiles. You know how we would, you know, take an entire fleet and transition between one tile and another. We now actually send them, use their AI, patrol AI, to send them to different locations. So if we actually get in a strike or something like that, any kind of flying ship, and just gun it into the distance, we'll actually be transitioning territory. Oh, damn it, we can't get them. Let me see if I can go all the way down here and then shoot all the way up and see how high that'll get me. But yeah, we'll have a big open world map with, I don't know how the resource points are going to be on that, but... Damn it. I just can't get him. Bollocks. Alright, in that case, where's my ship? Where's my ship? What's left of my ship, that is. Alright, let's get back to what's left of my ship. I can quickly repair it and see if I can take this guy down. I will get you. Grenade launcher! I'm not going to be able to hit. If I can't hit him with the miniguns, I'm pretty sure my GL's not going to outrange that. Wait, where the hell am I going? God damn it. Oh, hey, it really beats itself there now. I'm kind of actually surprised that the laser is still intact, and it's... Wow, it is trying to just, like, ram itself up that mountain right now. It's actually kind of funny. even more funny is that the enemy ship still hasn't really put much of a dent in other than taking out my missiles. Speaking of which, I probably still have the long-range missiles, so let's see if I can nail them with that. Alright, long-range missiles! Are you ready? Fire! Take him down, my beauties. Take him down. That I may board him. Yep, you got him. They got him. Let's go. Board him up. Let's see if I can take this thing hostage. No, you don't! Oh, damn you to hell. Oh, wow, I think my thing's actually flipping. I just couldn't make it to it in time. Damn it. Oh, God, yeah, no, it is literally flipping. It's flipping for joy! Yeah, no joy. Spin, damn you. Yep, nope, she's toast. She's toast. I tried. I tried my best, but telekinesis isn't enough. Nope, it's not gonna happen. Fire the death beams one last time. Fire the death beams. No, no. I guess not. Ah, well. Anyway, let's go ahead and just reload the previous game. So, yeah, let me actually go through here and kind of show off some of the things that, well, I'll at least mention it. I'll also post the new campaign mechanics, both the forum post and the actual Steam post, just in case, in the description down below. But, yeah, I'll have a big open map, continuous game world, no need for scene changes or load times. The game world still contains every AI fleet that'll be out there, both in-play and out-of-play vehicles. I'm assuming that every single one of their vehicles will be out-of-play. Essentially, this means that they're not loaded onto the map. They still exist in that tile, in code-wise, like as a reference number, but they don't actually spawn in. That way, they can move these guys across the map. They don't have to worry about load issues with that. It also means that we will have a bit of a set limit with how many vehicles we'll actually be able to keep with us. I'm assuming... Let me go back. Let me actually exit to the main menu here. Yeah, main menu. I don't care about that. If it doesn't save, it doesn't really matter. I'm assuming that's where leadership will start to come in real handy. Let me go to my character sheet here. Leadership allows us to carry 4 constructibles. I think that's just... the size of your command, number of blocks you can carry with you when you jump into another boarding section, and the number of vehicles you can take with you. So I'm assuming this will be a major part to how many vehicles we can have active at a time, although I don't know this for sure. This is just my assumption. Now, we'll be able to do something like, say, put an entire fleet of ours outside of play, just out of play, and send them somewhere. Just order that big fleet we assigned to go to this zone and maybe, you know, go to a resource zone or something. Likewise, we'll be able to take a resource miner, put him out of play, and have him continue, like, we'll still get the resources from him as if we were sitting there active with it. This is actually really an intriguing system. I'm assuming, though, that if 2 fleets that are inactive meet, then obviously a battle will occur. I don't know 100% if... and like the character is not there, if they'll just, you know, auto battle depending on points or something, or if they'll spawn each fleet in and begin an AI battle. I'm not 100% how this is going to work until I actually get to, you know, play it and test it and see how it goes. But still, this is really, really freaking cool sounding. So we'll have to send our units across the map like that faster. So this is going to be, you know, really good for small, fast fleets of ships. So a lot of like 5 or 6 smaller, fast ships that we just send out. Maybe like we can have like a Shrike squadron or something, or just a bomber squadron set aside somewhere in out of play mode. And the moment we like need them, we can just, you know, call them up. Maybe we can transfer to it. Because our character will be able to warp around between fleets and activate them. So that's how we'll be able to, you know, jump around the map and get to these battles. So that's really interesting. Battles happen by moving fleets near each other on the map. Once a certain range, they enter a blockaded status. Oh, here we go. Which means they cannot move or do anything once a player warps to the blockaded fleet and turns a force or more in play. The battle starts. Which is interesting. Say we send a fleet of... What is it they mentioned here? Oh yeah, the maximum number of blocks in play is one of the things we can actually tweak, so there can be like a maximum of 10,000 blocks, so 10,000 chip blocks, or 100,000, depending on what you want to do for that. Number of blocks you can spawn depends on the relative fleet battling sizes, so if you bring 40 ships and they bring 5, when the game begins with spawning, you will have 8 units against their 1 unit. That's what I mean for that. So yeah, if they have... We have 100 units, they have 10 units, it would be 10 to 1 our favor. 10 ships to their 1 ship. Now, speaking along those lines, say it was, you know, we had 100 ships, they had 10 ships, and it was 10 to 1. I don't know if that means, you know, we could have 10 small, tiny, little weak ships versus their 1 giant, like, Goliath, titan of death and destruction. So I don't know how that's going to balance it out like that. But, yeah, either way, this is just a freakingly amazing sounding system. I absolutely can't wait to see this happen. One thing I almost wish would happen as well is an integration of an almost radar system to go with this. Since we now have this big open world
that we just send our fleets, like, you know, real time towards, as it were. You know, they're going to travel across the map as fast as they can travel across the map, as fast as they're made to travel across the map. Rather than having all the enemy, like, being able to see where the enemy units are, kind of like how it is now where they send a fleet towards us and we can actually see, like, him departing from the base and coming towards us, I'd rather like to see some kind of radar system where we have to, you know, build these various, like, small, medium, large radar systems that have various ranges to them. Things like subs could be a lot harder to detect because they're, you know, spend most of their time underwater. So, could even have to have some kind of sonar specifically for them. But anyway, regardless, mass production, let's see here. Make a game more user-friendly. You can now warp the character directly from vehicle to vehicle. You can even sit the player in an out-of-play vehicle and admire the view as it moves with the fleet. Ah, I see. That's interesting. The benefit of this being, I quote the following functionality, mass production, producing units painfully by spawning in vehicles, turning them out of play and adding them into the fleet with repair tentacles in them. Oh, I see. Essentially, if the fleet is out of play, I'm not exactly sure how well this is going to work with this. I'm assuming, oh man, I'm actually just not sure how this is going to display, to be completely honest. Because it could either be that when you're on this fleet, you can see every single vehicle in the fleet, you know, going with the fleet. Or it could be that just the vehicle that you spawn in is, you know, the one that's showing up and actually being rendered. So I'm going to have to ask about, well, it's almost the 8th anyway, which is when it's hopefully coming out. So I guess we'll be finding out soon. Oh my god, that thing looks sexy. I mean, I just wish I could design something that cool looking. Look at that thing. It's so freaking cool. I'm talking about that other ship, like, back. Go away, pod racer. Go away. You know, let me actually go to the, let me remove the UI here quickly so we can admire these sexy battles. I wish I could swap between these rather than just automatically doing it, but ah well. Anyway. But yeah, either that it's going to render all the vehicles in our fleet and at the same time while we're traveling wherever the hell we're going, or it's only going to render our own and then any other vehicles that we produce via the sub spawner, the vehicle spawner. Would get, you know, would be created behind us, and then would be put out of play in the, like, the fleet's stock, or whatever you want to call it. So I'm not really 100% sure how that's going to work, but that's going to be very interesting. But yeah, building resource, yeah, as I said, building resource miners in every resource zone, turning them out of play, and getting the full resource, full resources from gathering. Oil drilling, crystal farming, all that kind of stuff. Creating fighter squadrons that can zip across the map and join you in battle. So, I'm assuming along those lines, say you get into a blockade. I'm not sure if you can warp outside of that. Maybe you could create a quick fighter squadron back at base and then send them at the units to reinforce them and say they're, like, you know, at a major disadvantage and then engage the battle. But I do hope that while these blockades are happening, we're taking some kind of loss over time. I think we are, but I'm not 100% on that. Because that would be, that would make more sense. Otherwise, you could just leave the blockade there forever and, you know, nothing would ever happen. You could send, like, one unit to blockade an entire fleet. And just trollolol all your way along. So I do hope there's something like that. I always was intrigued by this one here. It's such a simple design and it's really nice and cool. I don't use paddle wheels. I really don't use paddle wheels enough. I need to. I really do. I need to create some kind of, like, giant paddle wheel ship. Anyway. One other thing that's really cool, not going to be coming too soon at the moment because, you know, he put major, major time into updating the campaign here and getting that working. But another really cool thing that he's working on is changing up how custom cannons work and custom ammunition. Holy God, that thing looks so cool. Oh man, I want that so bad. Both of these vehicles here are just fighting each other. They just look so badass. I mean, obviously it's nose diving into the ground, so that's a bit of a design flaw right there, but goddamn. Still nice. But yes, as I was saying, new custom cannons. I should say more than custom cannons, it's more along the lines of custom ammunition for those custom cannons. So, it's essentially talking about turning cannons, like these ones right here, into something along the lines of missiles. So we'll have a separate ammo rack where we will make our custom ammunition. And something like this is what I want to make. Oh, it looks so good. So we'll have a separate ammo rack somewhere on the ship that will have our custom ammunition, and we'll be able to design it however we want to, put special warheads on it and all kinds of stuff like that. And then connect them via some piping or something like that, some ammo loader, to the actual cannon itself. So we'll have something like that cannon down there. Pardon me. Which will connect the autoloader up to, and it'll take the ammunition from that and send it out the barrels. So that way we have a bit of a separate system. We'll still have the regular ammo that we can use for the cannons if we don't want to customize, but if we do, then we can create some really, really cool ammunition. So that way we don't have to have these, you know, just gigantic, massive cannons that we already have now. We'll be able to have something small like this, yet still be able to output a really good amount of power. And I believe some people were mentioning that, I'm not sure if he's going to do it this way, he was going to add like a component to help increase accuracy, fins I believe it was. But they were mentioning that, you know, just a longer barrel, which kind of makes sense. A longer barrel, it means more accuracy in a way. So lengthening the barrels will increase the amount of accuracy we'll get out of it. And there's also things like an airburst charge, or an airburst timer, I should say. So we'll be able to create like little flak cannons on either side and or on, you know, anywhere on our ship. And that just sounds really freaking cool. Like, imagine setting up a flak cannon to detonate fragmentation rounds that scatter in the air. Oh my god, it just sounds so great. This guy is ridiculous and relentless. He is definitely one of my favorite developers. I absolutely just... Man, great guy. Just making an amazing game. Definitely do support the game. Speaking of which, I will be giving away my last copy of the game for the Child's Play event. So definitely do come around for that. I'll also be giving away a couple different games myself. I believe the QT has a bunch of stuff stocked up that they'll be giving away. So definitely do come check it out if you can. Again, description or link in the description down below. I'm hoping I might get the... I'm going to try and poke the dev a bit and see if he'll, you know... give us shout, like, come shout out or something, hang out for a minute or two and discuss the game. If he doesn't have time for that, you know, just, I'm still gonna play the game, you know. I'm still gonna go crazy with this new campaign and check it out, explore it, and then do some more videos on it for sometime next week. I don't know when, because I'm incredibly busy next week for work. But, yeah, I'm definitely going to try and get my videos up whenever I can, as soon as I can. So, anyway, guys, that's enough for the discussion today and the madness and the craziness we're doing here. Definitely thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Hopefully you all enjoyed. Definitely do check out the links for both the update as well as the forum. I'm actually going to link the general developer forum. That way you can get the the campaign update on there. You can see the update that he's talking about. Well... can't download the update, but you can read about it. You can see the one talking about the new ammo types and stuff like that, and a whole bunch of other plans that you might have for the game. Damn, I never did face this thing. I hope I do face it eventually. I really do want to. It looks like it would tear me apart, but my god, it's still so freaking cool. Anyway, thanks for watching. Have a great one. Catch y'all later. Dragon out. Peace.